This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. A bone tumor, also spelled bone tumor, is a neoplastic growth of tissue in bone. Abnormal growths found in the bone can be either benign noncancerous or malignant cancerous. Average 5-year survival in the United States after being diagnosed with bone and joint cancer is 67%. Contents 1 classification 11 primary bone tumors, 12 secondary bone tumors, 2 symptoms, 3 treatment, 31 chemotherapy and radiotherapy, 32 medication, 33 surgical treatment, 34 thermal ablation technique, 4 prognosis, 5 see also, 6 references, 7 external links. Classification: X-ray of a giant cell bone tumor in the head of the fourth metacarpal of the left hand and arm bone tumor. Bone tumors may be classified as primary tumors, which originate in bone or from bone-derived cells and tissues, and secondary tumors, which originate in other sites and spread metastasize to the skeleton. Carcinomas of the prostate, breasts, lungs, thyroid, and kidneys are the carcinomas that most commonly metastasize to bone. Secondary malignant bone tumors are estimated to be 50 to 100 times as common as primary bone cancers. Primary bone tumors. Primary tumors of bone can be divided into benign tumors and cancers. Common benign bone tumors may be neoplastic, developmental, traumatic, infectious, or inflammatory in etiology. Some benign tumors are not true neoplasms, but rather, represent hamartomas, namely the osteochondroma. The most common locations for many primary tumors, both benign and malignant, include the distal femur and proximal tibia around the knee joint. Examples of benign bone tumors include osteoma, osteoid osteoma, osteochondroma, osteoblastoma, enchondroma, giant cell tumor of bone, aneurysmal bone cyst, and fibrous dysplasia of bone. Malignant primary bone tumors include osteosarcoma, chondrosarcoma, Ewing sarcoma, fibrosarcoma, and other types, while malignant fibrous histiocytoma MFH, now generally called pleomorphic undifferentiated sarcoma primary in bone, is known to occur occasionally. Current paradigms tend to consider MFH a wastebasket diagnosis, and the current trend is toward using specialized studies, i.e. genetic and immunohistochemical tests, to classify these undifferentiated tumors into other tumor classes. Multiple myeloma is a hematologic cancer, originating in the bone marrow, which also frequently presents as one or more bone lesions. Germ cell tumors, including teratoma, often present and originate in the midline of the sacrum, coccyx, or both. These sacrocoxygeal teratomas are often relatively amenable to treatment. Stage 1A bone cancer, stage 1B bone cancer, stage 2A bone cancer, stage 2B bone cancer, stage 3 bone cancer. Secondary bone tumors, since, by definition, benign bone tumors do not metastasize, all secondary bone tumors are metastatic lesions which have spread from other organs, most commonly carcinomas of the breast, lung, and prostate. Reliable and valid statistics on the incidence, prevalence, and mortality of malignant bone tumors are difficult to come by, particularly in the oldest, those over 75 years of age, because carcinomas that are widely metastatic to bone are rarely ever curable. Biopsies to determine the origin of the tumor in cases like this are rarely done. Symptoms see also, cancer pain. The most common symptom of bone tumors is pain, which will gradually increase over time. A person may go weeks, months, and sometimes years before seeking help. The pain increases with the growth of the tumor. Additional symptoms may include fatigue, fever, weight loss, anemia, and/or unexplained bone fractures. Many patients will not experience any symptoms, except for a painless mass. Some bone tumors may weaken the structure of the bone, causing pathologic fractures. Treatment of bone tumors is highly dependent on the type of tumor. Chemotherapy and radiotherapy. Chemotherapy and radiotherapy are effective in some tumors, such as Ewing's sarcoma, but less so in others, such as chondrosarcoma. There are a variety of chemotherapy treatment protocols. For bone tumors, the protocol with the best reported survival in children and adults is an intra-arterial protocol, where tumor response is tracked by serial arteriogram when tumor response has reached. The other surgery is called Van Nes rotation or rotationplasty, which is a form of amputation, in which the patient's foot is turned upwards in a 180-degree turn, and the upturned foot is used as a knee. Types of amputation: leg below knee, above knee, cymes, hip disarticulation, hemipelvectomy or hindquarter, in which the whole leg is removed with one half of the pelvis, arm below elbow, above elbow, shoulder disarticulation, forequarter amputation of the whole arm, along with the shoulder blade and the clavicle. The most radical of amputations is hemicorporectomy, translumbar or waist amputation, which Removes the legs, the pelvis, urinary system, excretory system and the genital area, penis, testes in males and vagina, vulva in females. This operation is done in two stages. First stage is doing the colostomy and the urinary conduit. The second stage is the amputation. This is a mutilating operation and is only done as a last resort, e.g. when even pelvic excenturation does not work or in cases of advanced pelvic, reproductive cancers. Thermal ablation techniques over the past two decades, CT-guided radiofrequency ablation has emerged as a less invasive alternative to surgical resection in the care of benign bone tumors, most notably osteoid osteomas. In this technique, which can be performed under conscious sedation, a RF probe is introduced into the tumor nidus through a cannulated needle under CT guidance and heat is applied locally to destroy tumor cells. Since the procedure was first introduced for the treatment of osteoid osteomas in the early 1990s, it has been shown in numerous studies to be less invasive and expensive, to result in less bone destruction and to have equivalent safety and efficacy to surgical techniques, with 66 to 96% of patients reporting freedom from symptoms while initial success rates with RFA are high. Symptom recurrence after RFA treatment has been reported, with some studies demonstrating a recurrence rate similar to that of surgical treatment. Thermal ablation techniques are also increasingly being used in the palliative treatment of painful metastatic bone disease. Currently, external beam radiation therapy is the standard of care for patients with localized bone pain due to metastatic disease, although the majority of patients experience complete or partial relief of pain following radiation therapy. The effect is not immediate and has been shown in some studies to be transient in more than half of patients. For patients who are not eligible or do not respond to traditional therapies, i.e. radiation therapy, chemotherapy, palliative surgery, bisphosphonates or analgesic medications, thermal ablation techniques have been explored as alternatives for pain reduction. Several multi-center clinical trials studying the efficacy of RFA in the treatment of moderate to severe pain in patients with metastatic bone disease have shown significant decreases in patient-reported pain after treatment. These studies are limited, however, to patients with one or two metastatic sites. Pain from multiple tumors can be difficult to localize for directed therapy. More recently, cryoablation has also been explored as a potentially effective alternative, as the area of destruction created by this technique can be monitored more effectively by CT than RFA, a potential advantage when treating tumors adjacent to critical structures. Prognosis: the outlook depends on the type of tumor. The outcome is expected to be good for people with noncancerous benign tumors, although some types of benign tumors may eventually become cancerous. Malignant: with malignant bone tumors that have not spread, most patients achieve a cure, but the cure rate depends on the type of cancer, location, size, and other factors. See also bone scintigraphy references. Carrot, Seer stat fact sheets, bone and joint cancer, NCI, retrieved 18 June 2014. Procedure. Radiology 183-129-33 doi, 101,148, radiology 18,311,549,690 ISSN. Coagulation of osteoid osteoma compared with operative treatment. J bone joint surgam 86-815-21 ISSN. Atwell, Thomas D. 1 March 2013. Percutaneous image guided cryoablation of painful metastasis involving bone. Cancer 119-5-1033-1041 doi, 101,002, CNCR 27793 ISSN. Carcinoma in situ. Cancer metastasis. Primary tumor. Sentinel lymph node topography. Head, neck, oral, nasopharyngeal, digestive system, respiratory system, bone, skin, blood, urogenital, nervous system, endocrine system. Histology. Carcinoma, sarcoma, blastoma, papilloma, adenoma. Other precancerous condition. Paraneoplastic syndrome. Staging, grading, TNM, Ann Arbor. Prostate cancer staging. Gleason grading system. Dukes classification. Carcinogenesis. Cancer cell carcinogen. Tumor suppressor genes. Oncogenes. Clonally transmissible cancer. Oncovirus. Cancer bacteria. MISC research list of oncology related terms. History. Cancer, pain, cancer and nausea. VE tumors of bone and cartilage. ICD-0918-0-9269-C40-C41-D16-170-213. Diaphysis. Myeloid. Multiple myeloma. Epithelial adamantinoma. PNET. Ewing family. Ewing sarcoma. Metaphysis, osteoblast, osteoid, osteoma, osteoblastoma, osteoma, osteosarcoma, chondroblast, chondroma, echondroma, enchondroma, enchondromatosis, extraskeletal chondroma, chondrosarcoma, mesenchymal chondrosarcoma, myxoid chondrosarcoma, osteochondroma, osteochondromatosis, chondromyxoid fibroma, fibrous peripheral ossifying fibroma, fibrosarcoma. Epiphysis, chondroblast, chondroblastoma, myeloid, giant cell tumor of bone, other, ungrouped, notochord, chordoma, authority controlled, GND, 4123535-6 NDL, 0056683.